Namaste, students. We are in our first chapter of economic development, and today we will be doing demographic condition. Now, before I go deep into it, let me explain to you what does the term demography means. Demography is the study of population of any country based on such factors like age of the population, race, the income, the literacy, etc. Now, both the government and the non-government organization use this demographics to learn about the characteristics of the population. Why? Because with this, it will help them to make the policy developments and the economic market research. Now, under the colonial rule, which we are talking about presently, that is characterized by two centuries of exploitation. Now, under the colonial masters, what the Indians were like? The Indians were more like a slave and they were like servants. So, the hunger and deaths became one of the common features of the colonial India. There was a first census which was carried on, and it was found that the Indian population growth was very uneven. Thereafter, it was decided that after every 10 years, there will be a census being carried out. Now, during this stage or the colonial period, it was found that the population, not the rate of population growth, was very high. Now, coming to the other social developmental indicators, like say for example literacy levels, we find that the literacy level was as low as 16% during that time, with the female literacy rate which was only 7%. So the women were in a worst of the conditions. Now, in this situation, the worst part was that the colonials took no steps to change the scenario. Rather, why? Because, you know, what they felt was that it was better that India was illiterate, because it was easier for them to tackle the illiterate people, make them slaves and impose restrictions on them. So colonial India was fighting to fill its empty stomach. This was further aggravated. There was no good public health facilities as well. So what was found was that this hunger-stricken state was thus a victim. There was airborne diseases, there were waterborne diseases, and in such a background, life expectancy. Now, what is life expectancy? It means the measure of the average time a person is expected to live. It was found that it was only 32 years. And if you see it in this present age, present state, it is 63 years of age. That is, on an average, a person is expected to live around 63 years. Again, if we are talking about the mortality rate, which means the number of deaths, it was found that during that colonial period, it was skyrocketing, with infant mortality rate being 218 per thousand, which in contrast now, if you see, it is 63 per thousand. That is, 63 out of the total per thousand children are face deaths. But earlier it was 218. So there are no official records if you see about poverty. Poverty we cannot say much now. But what we find was that Indian population, if we talk about the Indian population, it was living under poverty, constant fear of diseases, there was starvation, and there was a lot of deaths. So if I put it into a nutshell, that is, the demographic profile during the colonial rule was really in a very bad state, or what we can say, it was in a horrible state if we compare it with for a human standard. So we will keep the demographic conditions till here, and in the next class we will start with the infrastructure during the colonial rule. Namaste.